done at all. Like, I know they've been around doing, I don't know, sister stuff, but like, sisters. Have we actually seen them around, like walking around Lake Miri?
Occasionally, but they stay pretty isolated.
If we try to approach them, do they keep maintain that isolation?
Am I echoing, by the way?
Not right now.
That's weird. It keeps showing my light is constantly on. Like it's picking up sound.
No, that's a bug, yeah.
Oh, it is? Okay.
Yeah, it's like a visual UI bug.
Gotcha. Okay, don't care then. No. No, not at all. You wouldn't get excommunicado.
Yeah.
It would be anyone. Would be...
Or a yeetist elitist.
If during the time we have, like, Clint could check in on them, he wants to talk with Sister Belladonna predominantly.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we're close to the door. Yes, you absolutely can do that. Let me clarify something that may have been a sort of misconception. A couple sessions back, I said Belladonna was like divine soul spec.
I assume that all sorcerers.
Yes, they all are. What I was trying to say was she's healing spec.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, okay. They all are, but they all also have specialties within them. Okay. If that makes sense.
Okay. Okay. So yeah, so they're all divine soul build, but.
She's like extremely divinely soul health build.
Yes, exactly.
They have different vocations of their divine cat power.
Yeah, so I didn't want to throw that misconception out there.
Okay, I appreciate the clarification.
So that means there is one. I'm curious as to which one of them is offensively specs.
Probably the half orc.
Maybe.
Which one of them? I wonder.
Maybe the giant one that ripped the tadpole out of Clint's eye.
For the one that's her enemy.
Probably the one.
Nah, she was so nice. Nah, she was so nice. What do you mean? That's impossible, bro. It's crazy talk.
So Clint goes to go talk to the sisters?
Well, only one of them's a sister right now.
Fair.
Look, yeah, so Clint will just try to approach, and assuming he doesn't get smitten. Smited? Smoted?
Isn't smitten like, oh, they're attractive?
I mean, that stops. I'm not changing my words.
I think it is smote, but, you know, shoes fitting and all that.
We're at the tree.
So you head over and you see her doing like a fairly relaxed meditation.
Quintal half quietly, which probably means nothing to a person from Lake Miri, walk up.
Crunch!
Just moves one pebble. She fucking detects it like fucking Toph does from Avatar.
You're basically walking with gongs on your feet.
It's a tactical decision. But yeah, Quintal walk up and just remark. Hope I'm not interrupting anything.
She takes a deep breath before opening her eyes slowly and looking at you. You are.
Oh. Wait, so you are art.
You aren't.
Okay. Got off at the end, so I want to make sure.
Don't suppose you know where Sister Belladonna is.
She told me to get some rest for the night.
And do you know where she went?
Not exactly sure.
Yeah, well, I got an idea of finding out. But before I do that...
The last she said was she needed to make sure the waters were purified.
The waters? Huh. Alright. Thanks for the heads up. How's the training going? Honestly, can't really figure out what the heck you guys are doing, but hopefully it's not too exhausting.
She just just like looks down and rubs her the tips of her fingers across her wrist. No, it is fine.
Look at her fingers. Are they like calloused or anything? Are they glowing with power?
No, but there's definitely a nervousness to the way she's rubbing against her wrist.
Quint will crouch down and pull out his amulet and just sort of grab her hands and like sort of wrap them around the amulet as if it's like a heat pad or something, like, you know, keeping your hands warm. I don't really know how this stuff works, but I think this is from a similar source to your powers. I hope it gives you some calm.
Shh, roll an insight.
Oh shit. Oh, I still got my I still got my halberd ring charge. Don't need it, let's go.
She definitely looks at you with this forlorn sadness. As she just says, it's best you don't touch me. I don't know if an outburst will happen.
Is this before I've made physical contact? I assume.
After.
If something happens to me, then you have my utter forgiveness, Miss Selena. These hands here. These hands are yours. These are hands of a good woman. Of a brave woman. Bringing light to the world. Getting hit by this. He shrugs. Eh. Won't be that bad.
Just because you can accept it does not mean I can.
Not at that. That's fair. Nonetheless.
Not looking to be responsible for the loss of life.
You've already done a lot in saving. Saving lives. Even if you don't realize it. Looked at the tree. I think your people have a lot of thanks to give you. And I hope that trend will continue. But more importantly, I hope that it's a path you're willing to walk. That's all. I know it was a hard decision.
What choice do I really have? We both know I didn't.
I know. I do. And I really wish there were other options. And I really hope that this path you're on will show you the wonders out there to make it at least a little bit more bearable. But for the time being, I'll let you get to rest, Miss Selena. And I'm going to try to hunt down Sister Belladonna. You feel free to hang on to that. I have a sneaking suspicion whenever sleep finds you, it'll make its way back to me. It just sort of does that. And I don't know how. But hopefully it's some comfort to you. In the meantime.
She just sort of nods and walks over against the tree and lays to its side and curls up under its roots.
Checking my inventory. I don't really have anything. I apparently have warm clothes and snowshoes. I'm assuming this was from way back in Fairfax. And I just never got rid of it. There's no way I still have this, right?
That seems like where it would be from, yeah.
He's got a spare set of, like, attire. Or he has, like, his own actual, like, jacket and stuff. So he'll just go over and lay it across her and then just begin walking off after making sure she's like tucked in, so to speak. And then Quint is going to do the same trick he used to find Miss Selena to find Sister Belladonna, which is say he's going to conjure his soul knife and throw it into the air and just keep looking around until he sees some bright form out there.
That, I mean, you don't need to look far. Roll a perception, though.
He looks towards the docks, because she said she was... Actually, wait, she's not purifying water. She's not purifying the entire... Do we have food stores?
There a well?
Yeah, well. Yeah.
I think on the other map there might be a well.
I don't recall that.
Okay. Well. Yep, she is down by the docks.
Oh, I got it. Yeah, so Quint will make his way over there.
As you do leave, you do hear just quiet sobbing.
Aww. Bradford, he's been camped here the whole time. On the right side of the map. Up.
No, he's not. Don't worry about it. He doesn't exist.
No deep serpent in the water, hopefully. Going to just begin make his way over to Sister Belladonna. He's actually going to try to sneak up to her. He's just curious as to, like, if her powers give her, like, an otherworldly detection. Beyond, like, just hearing. He's just gonna... Man, that's a trash roll for a plus 11. But yeah, he's gonna try to sneak up. And then just sort of observe her up on this upper... I don't know... landing here.
I mean, there's a maybe.
There's a world. So tell me there's a chance.
Let's see. Boop. You certainly do.
Oh. So she doesn't have an otherworldly detection. Interesting. That's just Quint's paranoia, I guess. Yeah, he's just gonna observe her for a while, see if he eventually notices him.
You see her sort of moving her hands in this rhythmic fashion that's almost like a whirlpool within itself. And you see the tides going in and out before she stops, takes a few deep breaths, reaches down into the water, grabs some of it before starting again. And after about the second time she does this, she reaches her hand up and there's some inky blackness on her glove.
So she's sort of literally extracting the dark from it.
Before she looks back over towards the island in the middle, and you just hear her take a deep breath and sigh. That's what I'll have to do for now.
Is she casting a spell in when she pulls this darkness out from the water? Is this a spell or is this some, like, guess more of a esoteric ritual?
Roll an arcana.
Ooh. Not bad. Could be better. Not bad.
15. No, it's certainly some magic. Can you identify it? No. But it's certainly powerful.
And she's not taking this water and, like, filling it. Like, in, like a container or anything with it, is she? She's just gentle. Jesus. As she's, like, remarking on, you know, this will have to do for now, Quint will just sort of speak aloud. A drop in the bucket, sister.
You see her tense up for a second. Before turning around.
And here I thought sisters were all-knowing.
Do not do that.
Duly noted, Sister Belladonna. I'll be sure not to in the future.
She turns around before you see her just swirl her hand and flick the blackness off, that it turns into like a gas before evaporating into the night sky. No. We are not all knowing.
Well, I know that now. The black ichor. The one they just cast off. That just flew off. You did the same thing to the mist before. Where does it go?
She just looks at this, like, concrete barricade that she's on the other side and reaches her hand up towards you.
He takes it.
As you help her over, she just looks up into the sky. Presumably, it goes back from whence it came.
Presumably. So no one really knows.
How could you know for sure?
Yeah, and sisters aren't all-knowing, so... I'll take you... take a word.
She just holds her arm out to her side, as if assuring you to take it and lock arm with her.
Quint will do so? A bit, like, hesitantly? Like, he's not sure where this is going.
Escort me back to the main town.
As you wish, sister. Although, let it be known, if we get in a fight on the way back, I'm not exactly the best body shield right now.
She just looks at you. No, I don't suspect you are.
Ouch.
But in that event, I will keep you safe.
Likewise. Came out here for a reason, Sister Belladonna. I wanted to ask, there's such a limited number of sisters. I assume that you all are relatively familiar with one another, yeah?
For the most part, yes.
So, I assume that also includes sisters in training.
She just closes her eyes and you see them fluttering beneath her eyelid. Yes, that would include your eyes, Lynn.
And you said you went all knowing. Call me a concerned older brother, but what does... what does your training entail? If nothing else, I'd also like to know for Miss Selena's sake.
While hold, like having her arm wrapped around yours, she just puts her other hand on top of yours. There are some things I can and cannot say. Just that's know.
Fair.
We are servants to all. We are not here to rule. We are not here to lord over. No sister will leave Renvark without being ensured that they will be safe to be around.
How do you know?
It's part of our oaths. We would never forsake them.
And I'm assuming that's all you can tell me about the training.
She just closes her eyes once more. It is not like your training.
Yeah, well, I suppose Aizen will be the best of the sisters in knowing that. She'd have to go through some of it.
She and Selena will not become casualties. we are blessed with the fortune enough to not need to produce soldiers in the way you do. We have time that you are not afforded.
How long do you think until me and my brothers can see our sister again? If you have any estimate on where her training's at. She did tell me that we need to send for her as soon as we're safe. And that's been weighing on my mind heavily.
I see. She closes her eyes as you walk. And opens them again a few seconds later. She says she is happy to hear it. And she will be in touch soon.
I'm sure there are many others that would be burdened lifted off their shoulders, but it just makes my intents more, sister. We live in strange times these days, so forgive me for being cautious. But thank you.
Cautious is the last thing you are.
Beg pardon?
Cautious is the last thing you are. You almost caused a serious incident.
I try to do my best.
Well, we know about good intentions and paving of roads.
I gotta admit, Sister Belladonna, when I first met you, I thought you'd be a lot meaner to me. But good to see you have a sense of humor and all of that.
I couldn't possibly hate you for doing what you think is best. But what you were doing was not best.
Perhaps I should rephrase what I said earlier then. I'm cautious for others, less so for myself. I'm well aware of that. I guess you can just call my nature. I imagine sisters have some ideal similar to that, right? With the great blessing you're bestowed.
Truly, you will not find one amongst us whose heart does not ache for those who are less fortunate. But temperance is a mighty blessing, one that will carry you far.
Well, say. I haven't exactly picked up the lesson on my using the watch, so. Can't promise it.
She just looks at you almost like a mother would a child. And it's never too late to learn. You're still quite young.
Say the same to you, sister. If we're going by appearances alone.
I am far older than you would imagine.
Okay. So appearances are deceiving in that front.
She just simply, like, reaches into her pocket and pulls out a little, like, compass-type compact that has a small mirror on it, and she pulls out a small little, like, scalpel-like thing and just looks at you before just taking it to her cheek and making a slight cut. And as she does, after a few seconds, it instantly heals back over. Regeneration is a powerful thing.
You're telling me. Duly noted, sister. Although in the future I would request that you cut something a bit less, obvious. Imagine my ass would get chewed out if I came back with you and a cut on your face.
I wager Alistair would do far worse.
As long as he's not like Riker.
Oh. She closes her eyes.
Hmm?
Ah, yes. The good captain. How is he?
I'm pretty sure I've taken more beatings from him than everyone else put together.
Hmm. I suspect you're not the worst he's had.
That seems impressive to me.
As you make your way nearer the town, she just closes her eyes once more and gets a small smirk.
Hmm?
Oh, nothing. Just reliving some wonderful moments of yours.
Went to, like, stop dead in his tracks. How? No, I shouldn't bother asking how. You can at least give a guy some warning next time.
She releases her arm from yours and just puts a hand on your face.
My helmet, my visor.
To you, the mind is like a lock and key, but to a sister, it's merely like a plane of glass.
Well, I guess I'd start standing it or something. Not a fan of that. But I hope you see from my memories that, despite all the beatings, I still respect Captain Riker.
That much is assured. But it was quite fun watching you receive them.
Your sense of humor is something else, sister. If you need anything, then feel free to ask me or any of my brothers or sisters. But if not, then have a good night.
She just holds a hand out and, you know, places her finger down, waiting for you to take it.
Takes it. Just like a... Do we know, like, procedures and protocols for handling, like, interactions? No. Not a kiss in their hand or something, is there?
Do you?
You gotta dab them up.
Dab them up? He won't kiss her hand, but he'll, like, put her hand to his, like, forehead. That sort of, like, reverential sort of bow, I guess is the best way to call it.
As you do so and look back up, she just has a fairly warm smile on her face. Good night, Glenn.
Sister.
Oh. And she just, like, snaps her fingers twice before poking you in the chest. And you feel this almost euphoric-like warmth coming from you that just radiates all throughout your body. That should keep you warm tonight. Since you're without a blink.
Thank you, sister. Happy to see we're on better terms. I thought you were pretty pissed at me. Have a good night.
Oh yeah, I got a thermal blanket. A spiritual thermal blanket.
Quintal. Since Quint doesn't need a blanket, he could sleep wherever he wants, including up on this roof.
Edge boy, roof time.
He's just gonna lean on the. It's not called railing. What is it called? Shinglings?
Yeah, shingle.
Shingles. I imagine they're clay and
yeah,
not the most comfortable, but you feel pretty good right now. So, does anyone else have anything they want to accomplish this night?
Go for it.
Okay.